If a bigger, heavier truck and a smaller, lighter vehicle collided head-to-head, which driver would get more hurt? Obviously, the driver in the smaller and lighter vehicle would get more hurt. It's common sense. What is an action-reaction pair? Newton's third law. For every action, there is a reaction of the same magnitude in the opposite direction. When one object exerts a force on another object, the energized object simultaneously exerts a force on the original object with the same magnitude, but in the opposite direction. How to survive a car crash, a collision experiment with basic physics formulas. The action and reaction forces are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. From the perspective of the action and reaction law, the force between the two cars in the collision are equal. If the collision forces are equal between the truck and the smaller vehicle, then even when they collide head-to-head, shouldn't they have the same amount of damage? If the force of impact they had on each other is the same, then why would the driver of the smaller vehicle suffer greater injury? For even when they collide with the same force, the smaller vehicle tends to sustain more damage than the truck. It's because of the difference in the materials each car is made of, meaning the difference in the consequences of a crash comes from the fact that the smaller vehicle is made up of thin steel plates, while the truck is made up of thick steel plates. Does the driver in the smaller vehicle suffer greater injury because the car itself is damaged more? If so, what would happen in an accident that does minimal damage to the car? Even then, the driver in the smaller vehicle would suffer greater injuries. F, force, equals ma, which is mass times acceleration, change in speed. I, impact, equals ft, which is force times applied time. When the big truck and the small vehicle crash, both cars experience the same magnitude of force, according to Newton's third law. The force and the impulse are proportional to mass and acceleration, which is change in speed. Even when the two cars receive the same impact, the big truck receives less acceleration because it has greater mass, and the small vehicle receives greater acceleration because it has lower mass. After the collision, the truck undergoes a small change in speed but continues in the same direction it had been going in. On the other hand, the small vehicle has a large change in speed and will be pushed in the opposite direction after the collision. Now, instead of looking at it from the perspective of the cars, let's look at it from the perspective of the drivers. Of the two, the truck driver experiences a small change in speed. But the driver of the small vehicle experiences a large change in speed. This means that the effect of the impact on the driver of the small vehicle is greater than on the driver of the truck. Now, shall we get down to the business of finding out how to survive a car crash? Let's say you're driving a car and you're faced with an unavoidable situation where you're heading right for a car coming from the opposite direction with an equal mass and speed. You have three choices. One is to get into a head-on collision with the car coming from the opposite direction. Another is to hit a sand dune. Or, lastly, to run into a rock that is not small but looks lighter than your car. Which option offers you the least amount of injury? The correct answer is the last one, to hit the rock. Here's why. If you collide with the other car or get stuck in the sand dune, your car won't get pushed to the side but will come to an immediate stop after impact. The force is mass times acceleration, and in both cases, the cars come to a stop at the instant of the collision, which results in the same acceleration, that is, change in velocity over time. That is why the force of two cars colliding into each other and stopping is equivalent to the force of hitting a sand dune and stopping. However, in the case of colliding with the rock, the car pushes the rock before coming to a stop, since the rock is lighter than the car. And since the car comes to a stop gradually by pushing the rock, the change in the acceleration is smaller. And, given the same impulse, it receives less impact force because the time it takes to stop when colliding with the rock is longer than the collision time with the sand dune or the car. In summary, the safest car is a big, heavy car made up of thick steel plates. So, it sounds like it would be safest just to ride around in a tank, right? Possibly, but more importantly, since impact is proportional to change in speed, it's important not to speed. And we should be careful to drive safely to avoid collisions.